Don, before we finish, there's been some breaking news about DNA and comparing DNA between humans and chimps. And from what I've heard, that the percentage that they used to say of how similar we are, it's actually like we're much more different than they think. Can you talk about that news?
So we've been told for decades that there's only a 1% difference between chimps and humans in our DNA. And there's a major paper published in Nature just recently where they what's happened is they've been able to decode or to decipher the full genomes of the great apes and people and humans and compare them properly. Now, this has not been possible until just recently because they've been incomplete. So this complete comparison shows that the difference between chimps and humans is about 15%, not 1%.
Wow, that's a big difference from 1% to 15 times the difference.
That's a big difference, that's right.
So with that huge difference, how could they have been so wrong with their previous estimates?
So way back, decades ago, they made a comparison, but they only compared the bits of the human DNA and the bits of the chimp DNA, which actually already aligned. So the things which actually were already similar, they compared those, and then they got this figure of 98 or 99%. And 1% difference doesn't sound like much, but if you think about the human DNA being 3,000 million letters, 1% difference is 30 million letters, which is about 10 Bible-sized books of information.
That's a lot.
So even the 1% is a big difference. But the evolutionists are happy with that because they could do a few calculations and they reckon they could account for that. But their calculations made huge assumptions in favor of evolution, and they assumed the differences were just random. But the differences aren't random, and this is a problem. Now, this one of the things that they've found in this research project just published is there's over 150 different gene families in humans that are missing in chimps. Now, right. A gene family is not a gene. It's actually a group of genes which are similar. But there's, I think it was 185 gene families present in humans that are missing in chimps. Now, just one of those gene families is enough to say evolution from a chimp-like common ancestor is impossible.
Because that's not one gene. That's a group of lots of genes.
It's a whole family of genes. And when they say a family which was missing from chimps, it means that there's nothing that's similar in chimps. So it's not as if you can grab this gene in the chimp and do a few mutations and get the one on the human. They're very, very different. And so this is a major problem for the evolutionary story.
Yeah. And so you said it's now they're saying 15% difference.
Yeah.
Are the evolutionists admitting that they were kind of wrong, or that it doesn't show evolution to be so strong of an idea?
Well, they can't deny it because the science is solid, but they have ways of trying to diffuse the problem. And they claim, for example, I've seen them claim that the difference is due to non-functional DNA. So it's supposed to be the junk. And so a lot of the DNA that couldn't decode in the past is actually what they call repetitive sequences. And this is where you get a sequence and that's repeated and might be repeated again. And the evolutionists claim that these repetitive sequences don't have any function. But it's not the case. In fact, the more and more we find that these repetitive sequences are involved in the three-dimensional structure of the DNA, of the chromosomes. You know, so the chromosomes in the nucleus, they're not just random. They're actually aligned with one another where similar genes actually interact. So a gene on this chromosome needs a gene on this chromosome to actually work together, and the chromosomes are actually put together and they're arranged in a way in which they're aligned. Well, these repetitive sequences, for example, are involved in that, and they're involved in a lot of other things as well. So the claim that this repetitive DNA is junk and therefore it doesn't matter, and so 15% doesn't matter,
yeah,
it doesn't stack up.
Yeah, so this 15% difference, would you say instead that actually points to you know, created kinds or different, God created them separately from the start.
It points to the fact there's a big difference between us and chimps. It's not a small difference, and it's a difference way beyond evolution. So they're 1%. They could try and explain that, making all sorts of assumptions in favour of evolution, but 15% is way beyond their ability to explain it.
Yeah. Well, this is really interesting. Is there other places where we can read about like the creation view on this and learn more about what this means in terms of whether evolution is true or not?
So Dr. Robert Carter, who's an expert in this field, has written an article on creation.com, and people can read the details there. They can also look up the original paper in Nature.
Oh, that sounds great. We'll put a link in the description below to one of those articles so people can check that out.
That's great, yeah.
Well, thanks, Don, for sharing all this information about DNA in chimps. I thought that was fascinating. Now, we've actually got a documentary called Evolution's Achilles Heels, and we're offering it as a free stream. And this documentary's got not just information about genetics and why evolution's wrong from the biology side of things, but other topics like astronomy, geology, all these other fields where people try to appeal to evolution being true, and the evidence actually shows the opposite.
That's right.
So can you tell us a bit more about this documentary?
Yeah, so here's a DVD version of the documentary, but it's also by streaming from the website. So it's available, and it'll be available for free. We have 15 PhD scientists involved in the production of this, a number of them from Creation Ministries International. Also, lots of really interesting animations. So, as you say, it covers a broad spectrum of claims that supposedly support evolution, but when you actually start digging into them, you find that they actually don't support evolution. That's why they're called Achilles heels. So when you look at the Achilles heels, you find they don't support evolution at all, like mutations. And mutations don't, we've been talking about those in reference to cancer. We deal with mutations on there, natural selection and things like that are supposed to be evolution. They don't work to actually explain evolution at all.
I think that's amazing that even these areas of science which evolutionists point to try and prove their theory, when you look at the detail, that actually shows that evolution isn't true. If you want to watch this documentary, have a look at the video description below. There's a link down there. Click on that and it's completely free and you can watch the documentary later. Thanks, Don, for sharing all this wonderful information with us today. I certainly feel much more equipped with this knowledge to explain to people why evolution isn't true.
Thanks, Michael. It's been a good conversation.